Today, I will tell you about four most famous archaeological sites in the world. What is archaeology? Basically, archaeology is the study of human history and prehistory through the excavation of prehistoric sites. An archaeological analysis of artifacts and other physical remains found at that site provide information about prehistoric societies and cultures. Archaeological sites are places where evidences of past activities are preserved. An archaeologist observes these places to find out more about human history. There are thousands of archaeological sites. However, in this video, I will tell you about the four most famous archaeological sites in the world. These sites are Great Pyramid of Giza in Egypt, Machu Picchu in Peru, Acropolis of Athens in Greece, and Terracotta Army in China. Great Pyramid of Giza. Pyramids were built for the tombs of Egyptian kings, and the largest pyramid ever made is in Giza. Giza is basically a city near Egypt's capital Cairo. Giza is famous for many pyramids built on the Giza Plateau about 4 centuries ago. It is mainly famous for a series of 3 pyramids that were built during the 4th dynasty of Egypt. These 3 pyramids belong to Khufu, the cruelest king ever, his son Khafre, and his grandson Menkaure. The pyramid you see in the middle was made by Khufu, and it is known as the Great Pyramid of Giza. It is also one of the 7 wonders of the world for many reasons. The Great Giza Pyramid was built between 2560 and 2580 BC. It is about 130.8 meters in height and 230.4 meters in width. Giza Pyramid remained the tallest building in the world for more than 3800 years, until 1311. The Great Pyramid of Giza was built with 2.3 million stones, and each of them had an average heft of over 2 tons. The main stuff that was used for construction were different types of limestones. There were chambers in the pyramid, one for the king Khufu, 2 for his wives, and some for his sons. Archaeologists say that the chamber of king was made with very heavy red stones, which weighed more than 80 tons. The finest limestones were used, and they were very hard. That's why the Great Pyramid of Giza stands tall yet after so many years. In this slide, I will tell you about another famous archaeological site, and it is Machu Picchu in Peru. It is a stone city and one of the most fascinating archaeological sites in the world. Machu Picchu is believed to be built in the 14th century by the 9th ruler of the Inca Empire, named as Pachacuti Inca Yupanqui. Archaeologists are still trying to solve many mysteries about Machu Picchu. For example, why Machu Picchu was built? Why was it abandoned? And how was it so precisely built? The city was built using hundreds of thousands of stones. The most interesting part is, it was built without using mortar to glue the stone together. And they were all shaped without using any iron tools. Despite this, the stones fit together so well that after 500 years, we cannot even fit a knife blade between them. Even if a small earthquake struck Machu Picchu, nothing will happen to it, and the stones will remain in the same position. The site has approximately 200 structures, including temples, tombs. Palaces, plazas, and fountains. So, why was Machu Picchu built? Some archaeologists believe that Machu Picchu was built as a religious site high in the mountains that the Inca worshipped, but some say that it was a military stronghold. However, after only 100 years of building, Machu Picchu was abandoned. Some archaeologists say that people of the Inca Empire left Machu Picchu because some Europeans brought many diseases there, such as chickenpox, and people were dying, so they left it isolated. Then Machu Picchu was covered with trees and remained hidden from the world until 1911, when an American Yale University professor, Hiram Bingham, explored this site and then spent his life exploring Machu Picchu and solving its mysteries. Nowadays, Machu Picchu is a place for visitors to come and pay homage to this amazing piece of history. It was designated as a World Heritage Site in 1983 by UNESCO, and also one of the new seven wonders of the world in 2007. Acropolis of Athens. The Acropolis of Athens is one of the most famous ancient archaeological sites in the world. Acropolis of Athens is in Greece and in the city of Athens. It was built in the 5th century by Pericles, who was a statesman of Athens in Greek civilization. Over the centuries, the Acropolis was many things: a home to the kings, a mythical home to the gods, a citadel, and a tourist attraction place. It was designated as the World Heritage Site by UNESCO in 1987. The term Acropolis means high city in Greek language, and it is built on a high elevated ground. Its height is 156 meters above the sea level. It also covers about 7 acres. It is made up of the finest limestones, and it is also located on the top of a limestone hill. It took thousands of artisans to build it, and it took about 9 years. During the Greek civilization, many religious festivals were celebrated in the Acropolis of Athens. The Greeks also built homes for their rulers in the Acropolis of Athens. The Greeks also built a temple dedicated to their god Athena, and this temple is called Parthenon. Parthenon is the most famous surviving building of the ancient Greece. It is huge, and its pillars are built with a slight curve that tricks the eye into thinking that they are straight. There is also a 40 feet high statue of their god Athena as a centerpiece in the temple. Over time, Parthenon has functioned as a temple for the Greeks, a treasure for the Venetians, as a church for the Byzantine Empire, a mosque for the Turks, and a fortress for the Ottoman Empire. Terracotta Army is a collection of terracotta sculptures in China, which were made during the Chinese civilization by the Emperor Qin Shi Huang in 256 BC. Before telling you the information about Terracotta Army, let me tell you the history of it, that why was it made. In the early dynasties of Chinese civilization, people believed in afterlife. So when an elite person was killed, he was buried in a tomb and some people were sacrificed with him. People didn't like the sacrifice and they started to criticize it. Instead of human sacrifice, terracotta figures were buried with the elite. Let me tell you that terracotta is a material used for sculpturing. These figures were carved very carefully and all had different facial features. They were made like a real soldier. They also had different headgears, and from their tags, their ranks were also visible. They were also colored brightly. These colors were taken out from plants and different flowers. But after being buried in ground, their color disappeared. Well, this was the army, of course made of terracotta, that the emperor Qin Shi Huang thought would protect him in the afterlife. He built more than 8,000 soldiers, 130 chariots with 520 horses and 150 cavalry horses, which were all buried near the tomb of Emperor Qin Shi Huang. In fact, this terracotta army was found in 1974 accidentally, when a group of farmers were digging a well and found some pieces of sculptures. Then a whole team came and they dug out the terracotta army. Now the terracotta army is preserved in China in a shelter and people can go to visit it. This army was recognized as the World Heritage Site in 1987 by UNESCO. Many people visit it every day. Thank you friends for watching my video. See you later with another Infugal video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel Infugal.